Very good morning to all. Welcome to the session of Unit 6, Fuel Cells, Hybrid Power Plant and Power Factor Improvement for Session 50, Department of Collegiate and Technical Education, Government of Karnataka. Here we are going to discuss of a course that is subject Electrical Power Generation of Department of Electrical and Electronics Engineering. Today in this session, we are going to discuss what is the meaning of power factor and its significance, causes of low power factor. In the contents, introduction, next meaning of power factor and its significance, causes of low power factor, at last we will see multiple choice questions. Introduction. The electrical energy is the most exclusively generated, transmitted and distributed in the form of alternating current, as we know. Therefore, the question of the power factor immediately comes into picture. Most of the loads, for example, induction motor, arc lamps, are inductive in nature, hence have a low lagging power factor. The low power factor is highly undesirable as it causes an increase in current, resulting in additional losses of active power in all the elements of power system, from the power station generator down to the utilization devices. In order to ensure most favorable condition for a supply system, from engineering and economical standpoint, it's very important to have a power factor that is close to unity as possible. Before going to power factor, we will see some terminologies. What is meant by active power? Active power, which is measured in watts, normally shown as kilowatt, provides the working part of the power system. It is a working part of the power system. For example, to produce heat, light, motion, running a motor, etc. Second is reactive power. Reactive power, which is measured in volt ampere reactive, or normally it is shown as KVAR. It only maintains the electromagnetic field and provides no working part of the power system. And it is acts as a supportive power. Next, apparent power, measured in volt amperes. Apparent power is measured in volt amperes. And it is normally shown in KVA. Provided both working and non-working part of the power system. That means KVA includes both active power and reactive power. Power factor is an expression of energy efficiency. It is usually expressed as a percentage, and lower the percentage, less efficient power usage. First meaning or definition is power factor, it is a cosine angle between voltage and current. Second type of definition is it is a ratio of resistance to impedance. Third way of defining is active power by apparent power. Cos phi is equal to active power by apparent power. Next is significance of power factor. As the power factor, that is cos phi, increases, the ratio of real power to apparent power increases and approaches to unity. While the angle decreases, the reactive power decreases. You can see in a diagram, power factor angle. When the angle is increased, it approaches to unity. Power factor is described as leading if the current waveform is advanced in phase with respect to voltage, or lagging when current waveform is behind the voltage waveform. You can see in a diagram. Increase in power factor. That means increasing power factor means the ratio of real power to apparent power. Ratio of real power to apparent power increases and approaches to unity. As the power factor decreases, the ratio of real power to apparent power also decreases, the angle theta increases and reactive power increases. From the diagram, you can understand if Q, that is reactive power, is more, the power factor will be less. If the reactive power is less, the power factor reaches to unity. You can see in a diagram both lagging and leading power factor. Power factor is described as a leading. You can see in a diagram leading power factor. If the current waveform is advanced with phase with respect to voltage, because the definition is the phase angle between voltage and current. You can see a simple analogy to explain power factor is that of a cappuccino. In the diagram, you can able to see here the mug must have sufficient capacity to contain both the coffee and the fourth, corresponding to the total power. Actually, on the top, the fourth represents the reactive power and the liquid presents the real power. From this, what we can understand means we only gain real value from the liquid. Andre, iga coffee alli nore melgade fourth anta helidre nore coffee andre a liquid content. Iga navu store ge hogi angdi ge hogi coffee shop ge hogi nav enadru coffee na nav cappuccino na order madidre ee liquid content enide ade navu price ge kottira anta siga anta worth value. ಆ ಫೋರ್ತ್ ನೊರೆ ಅನ್ನೋದೇನಿದೆ ಅದು ನಮಗೆ ಲಾಸ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆನ್ಸ್. ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಪವರ್ ಇಸ್ ಫೋರ್ತ್, ದ ರಿಯಲ್ ಪವರ್ ಇಸ್ ಕಾಫಿ. ರಿಯಲ್ ಪವರ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇದ್ದಷ್ಟು ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಪವರ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ನಮಗೆ ಕಾಫಿ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್, ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ ಕಂಟೆಂಟ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇದ್ರೆ, ನೊರೆ ಕಂಟೆಂಟು ಕಡಿಮೆ ಇದ್ರೆ, ನಾವು ಕೊಟ್ಟಿರೋ ಅಂತ ದುಡ್ಡಿಗೆ ನಮಗೆ ವರ್ತ್ ಆಗುತ್ತೆ. ಓಕೆ, ದ ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ರಿಯಲ್ ಪವರ್. The useful part of the coffee we want, while the fourth is just resultant of pouring the coffee into mug. Iga coffee navu mug olagade pour madbekare, iga coffee na navu pour madbekare navu yavade karanakku nore na avoid madak sadhya illa. Nore andre supportive power tara, andre reactive power is a wattless component, it is a supportive power. Adre adashtu kadme nore ಪ್ರಮಾಣ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಮಾಡಿ ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಮಾಡದೆ ರಿಯಲ್ ಪವರ್, ಅದನ್ನೇ ಪವರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಅಂತ ಹೇಳ ಉದ್ದೇಶ. ಓಕೆ, ದ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಕಾಫಿ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ಎ ಅಪಾರೆಂಟ್ ಪವರ್. ಟೋಟಲ್ ಪವರ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಕಾಂಬಿನೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ರಿಯಲ್ ಪವರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಪವರ್. ದ ಎಂಟೈರ್ ಕಾಫಿ ರೆಪ್ರೆಸೆಂಟ್ಸ್ ದ ಅಪಾರೆಂಟ್ ಪವರ್ ಅಂಡ್ ವಾಟ್ ಯುವರ್ ಎನರ್ಜಿ ರಿಟೈಲರ್ ಚಾರ್ಜಸ್ ಯು. ಈಗ ನೀವು ಮಗ್ಗಲ್ಲಿ ಅರ್ಧ ಕಾಫಿ ಇರಲಿ, ಅರ್ಧ ನೊರೆ ಇರಲಿ, ಅಥವಾ ಮುಕ್ಕಾಲು ಭಾಗ ಕಾಫಿ ಇರಲಿ, ಕಾಲು ಭಾಗ ನೊರೆ ಇರಲಿ, ಅಥವಾ 3/4, ನೀವೇನೇ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್ ತಗೊಂಡ್ರು ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಮಾತ್ರ ಟೋಟಲ್ ಮಗ್ಗಿಗೆ ಕೊಡಬೇಕಾಗತ್ತೆ. ಅದರಲ್ಲಿ ನಮಗೆ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಕಾಫಿ ಬಂದು ಕಡಿಮೆ ನೊರೆ ಬಂದರೆ ಕಸ್ಟಮರಿಗೆ ಅಡ್ವಾಂಟೇಜ್, ಅದರದ್ದು ಮೀನಿಂಗ್. ಓಕೆ, ಮೋರ್ ಲಿಕ್ವಿಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಲೆಸ್ ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಹೈ ಪವರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್. ಯು ಶುಡ್ ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಇನ್ ದಿಸ್ ಅನಾಲಜಿ. ಫಾರ್ ಅಪಾರೆಂಟ್ ಪವರ್ ಎ ಲ್ಯಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಮೇಡ್ ಅಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಟೂ ಪಾರ್ಟ್ಸ್. ಅದೇ ರೀತಿ ನಾವು ಹೇಳ್ದಂಗೆ ಕಾಫಿ ಮತ್ತೆ ಫೋರ್ತ್. ಓಕೆ, ನೌ ಐ ಥಿಂಕ್ ಯು ಅಂಡರ್ಸ್ಟುಡ್. ಇಫ್ ದ ಫೋರ್ತ್ ಇಸ್ ಎಸ್, ನೊರೆ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಇದ್ರೆ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಪವರ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ, ರಿಯಲ್ ಪವರ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ರಿಯಲ್ ಪವರ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇದ್ದು ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಪವರ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಇದ್ರೆ ಪವರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಪವರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇದ್ರೆ ನಮಗೆ ಅಡ್ವಾಂಟೇಜ್ ಇದೆ. ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ you can see the waveforms with type of load. Basically we should know there are three types of load. One is resistive load, inductive load and capacitive load. In this inductive first one is resistive load, the power factor is a phase shift between the voltage and current waveforms assuming both sinusoidal. The greater the angular difference up to the maximum 90 degree, the higher the reactive power component. First, in this diagram, you can see first circuit, it is pure resistive circuit. That means current and voltage are in phase. That means they are in same phase. That means it is power factor will be equals to 1 unit. In the second diagram, you can see the inductance. The inductance, by the nature, you can see the waveform. Current will lag the voltage by 90 degree. That means the maximum value that can be lagged. The maximum phase angle that can be created is 90 degree. 90 degree means more higher reactive power component. If the higher reactive power component means the power factor is very, very low. That means in inductive circuit or in inductive loads, power factor will be very, very low. Next, if we considering an inductive load, the power factor will be lagging due to which the current is lagged behind the voltage. While in capacitive load, the angle goes opposite. You can see in a diagram, in capacitive load, the current leads the voltage by 90 degree. You can see in a diagram. An important role in AC circuit depends on the load. As we know that lower the power factor, higher the load current. Higher the power factor, lower the load current. The current which taken by a device is less if the power factor is high. In capacitor, the power factor will be more than 1. In inductor circuit, the power factor will be less than 1. In resistor, pure resistor circuit, power factor will be equals to 1. Next, you can see a simple diagram, example. Assume that you are having a 1 kilowatt of load is connected to a 250 volts AC supply. Iga nimma manele ondu 100,000 watt do ondu iron box ide. Or 1 kilowatt load ondu element ide anta ankolu equipment. Iga navu moore condition alli separate agi discuss madidivi. Ondu unity power factor iddagenu. Power factor ಸ್ವಲ್ಪ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಆದಾಗ 0.8 ಇದ್ದಾಗೇನು ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಲ್ಯಾಗಿಂಗ್. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಪವರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಈಸ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 0.4. ಪವರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಇನ್ನೂ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಇದ್ದಾಗ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಯಾವ ರೀತಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ? ಈಗ ನಾನು ಮುಂಚೆ ಹೇಳಿದೆ, ಏನು ವೆರಿ ಇಂಪಾರ್ಟೆಂಟ್ ಥಿಂಗ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಲೋ ಪವರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಹೈ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಡ್ರಾ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ, ಹೈ ಪವರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಲೋ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಡ್ರಾ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಎಕ್ವಿಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಆರ್ ಎ ಮೆಷಿನ್. ಈಗ ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, we know that the formula P is equal to VI cos theta for single phase supply. I is equal to P by V cos theta. IA is equal to, we know that P is equal to 1000 kilowatt divided by 250 into 1. That means 1 is power factor is equal to 1. The answer will be 4 amps. For unity power factor, the equipment which draw the current will be 4 amps. Case 2, if the power factor is 0.8, the same equipment which is drawn will be 8 amps. Case 3, if the power factor is 0.4, 1000 divided by 250 into 0.4, if you calculate, you will get 10 amps. From this above example, we can conclude that if the power factor goes on decreasing, the current drawn by the equipment goes on increasing. That means if the current drawn by the equipment or a machinery goes on increasing, means ultimately we are paying a much electricity bill. Ultimately, I hope understood this example. Next, you can see causes of low power factor. What are the causes of low power factor? There are many causes. First is, the main cause of low power factor is inductive load. As in pure inductive circuit, as we discussed before, current lags the voltage by 90 degrees. This is the large phase difference. This is the actually large phase difference. Phase angle between current and voltage causes zero power factor. If the phase difference is 90 degree between voltage and current, that means lagging, the power factor will be zero. Lower the power factor has several disadvantages in power system. The main effect of low power factor is to increase the current, and here increases the losses. If the current is increased, if the losses are more, ultimately the overall system efficiency will be reduced. So that the low power factor is not desirable for us from the economic point of view. First one is single phase and three phase induction motors. Usually induction motor works. Induction motor having three categories, it will work at low power factor during no load. The power factor will be zero at no load. If it is a small load, if the motor is applied for a small load, the power factor ranges will be 0.2 to 0.3. If it is full load, it will be around 0.8 to 0.9. The basic reason behind the low power factor is increasing demand of reactive power. ಈಗ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಪವರ್ ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇದ್ದಾಗ ನಮಗೆ ಪವರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಈಗ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಪವರ್ ನಾವು ಲೋಕಲಿ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಮಾಡಬೇಕು ಅಂದ್ರೆ, ಇಫ್ ಅಟ್ ಎನಿ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ಇನ್ ಎ ಸಿಸ್ಟಮ್ ದೇರ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಬ್ಯಾಲೆನ್ಸ್ ಬಿಟ್ವೀನ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಪವರ್ ಡಿಮ್ಯಾಂಡ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಜನರೇಷನ್, ದೆನ್ ದ ಪವರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಅಟ್ ದ ಪಾಯಿಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಯೂನಿಟಿ. ಎಕ್ಸಾಂಪಲ್, ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಇಂಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಲೋಡ್ ಲೈಕ್ ಇಂಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಮೋಟಾರ್, ಇಟ್ ಡ್ರಾಸ್ ಲ್ಯಾಗಿಂಗ್ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಡೆನ್ಸ್ ರಿಯಾಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಪವರ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಜನರೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್ ಮ್ಯಾಗ್ನೆಟಿಕ್ ಫ್ಲಕ್ಸ್ in its air gap. Thus, inductive loads requires reactive power to meet the requirement, so that they will draw very large lagging current from the system and hence causes for the low power factor. Next point is varying load in power system. Varying load means in industry, most of the 80% or 90%, we can say 90% of the load will be a induction motor. Either there may be single phase, three phase, or both. We know that the induction motor operators are poor power factor. At no load or light load condition, it can be near to zero. Or light load condition, it can be 0.3. At full load, it can be reached up to 0.85 to 0.9 power factor. Induction motor is one of the major causes of low power factor. Next one is industrial heating furnace. The load on the power system is not always constant. It varies during the entire day. It is more during morning, but less during the rest of the period. During the light load condition, the supply voltage decreases. This increases the magnetizing current. This increases the magnetizing current that leads to low power factor in motors. As part of the induction motor, varying load means, as we know that the load on the power system is always varying, during the low load period, supply voltage is increased, which increases the magnetizing current, which causes the decreased power factor. And today we know that we are having a interconnected power systems. According to the different seasons, time, type of loading conditions on power system may vary, and they are varying. Our power system is always dynamic. It is varying time by time. There are peaks as well as low load periods. Peak value means much high demand. Low load means there is a minimum demand. When the system is loaded lightly, the voltage will increase and the current drawn by the machine also increase. This is low power factor. Another point is industrial heating furnace. Electrical discharge lamps, say for example, high intensity discharge lamps, arc lamps which also operates at low power factor because they are inductive type transformers. Once again, transformers also operates at low power factor. Harmonic currents, the presence of harmonic currents in the system also reduces the power factor. In some cases, due to the improper wiring or electrical accidents, a condition known as three-phase power imbalance occurs. This will also result in low power factor. Next, what are the low power factor effects? One is large line losses. That means copper loss will be more. Next, it is a large KVA rating and the size of electrical equipments. That is also one of the cause of low power factor. It affects greater size of conductor. If the conductor size is more, ultimately the cost will be more on the material. Next is poor voltage regulation. The voltage regulation will be very poor and there is a large voltage drop. Next is lower the efficiency. If the losses are more, ultimately the efficiency of the system will get reduced. And penalty from the electrical power supply company on low power factor. If the power factor is not maintained at 0.95 or a permissible limit, the penalty will be charged by the distribution companies. Next we will see MCQs. What is the maximum value of power factor? Is the first question. The options are 0.5, 1, 1.5, 0.95. The answer will be 1. The maximum value of power factor is achieved is 1. It will be varies from 0 to 1. If it is leading power factor, that is more than 1. It is lagging power factor, it is less than unity. The ideal power factor will be 1, means maximum value in a resistive load. In resistive load, current and voltage are in phase, so there is no phase angle difference. If there is no phase angle difference, means power factor will be maximum, that is 1. Okay, second question. Active power and apparent power are respectively represented by, the options are kilowatt and kVAr, kVAr and kVA, kVA and kVAr, kilowatt and kVA. Active power and apparent power. The answer will be D, kilowatt and kVA. Because active power will be rated in watts or kilowatts, as we discussed in earlier slides. And reactive power will be in VAR or kVAR. The apparent power is a combination of both active power and reactive power, that is represented by kVA. And the answer will be D. Okay, next question. Which among the following happens in a low power factor? Options are large kVA rating of the equipment, greater conductor size, reduced handling capacity of the system, D, all of the above. The answer will be all of the above. If the low power factor occurs, these are the problems we will face. Large kVA rating of equipment will be required. And the conductor size will also be increased. Why? Because the low power factor means the equipment will draw more current. More current means the conductor size should have to be increased. And the handling capacity of the system will also get reduced. Okay, the answer will be D for question number 3. Next question, question number 4. Low power factor is usually not due to discharge lamp, arc lamp, incandescent lamps, induction furnace. The answer is incandescent lamps. As we know, iga now manelella nodidivi incandescent lamp. Even though we are using choke na ale type of incandescent lamps na, sorry, incandescent lamps anta heladre navu arc lamps andre naven helbodu tungsten element ira anta bulb na incandescent lamps anta karithivi. So tungsten element andre it is nothing but a resistance. So resistive load idre power factor ಜಾಸ್ತಿ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಅಂದರೆ ಇಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಆಲ್ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಲ್ ಒನ್ ರೆಸಿಸ್ಟಿವ್ ಲೋಡ್. ಈಗ ಇಂಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಲೋಡ್ ಇದ್ರೆ ಡಿಸ್ಚಾರ್ಜ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಪ್ ಇಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇಂಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಲೋಡ್, ಆರ್ಕ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಪ್ಸ್ ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಇಂಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಲೋಡ್, ಇಂಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಫರ್ನೆಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ಇಂಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಲೋಡ್. ಇಫ್ ದ ಇಂಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಲೋಡ್ ಇಸ್ ದೇರ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಎ ಕಾಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೋ ಪವರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್. ಹಿಯರ್ ಇನ್ ದ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಲೋ ಪವರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಇಸ್ ನಾಟ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು, ದ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಇನ್ಕ್ಯಾಂಡೆಸೆಂಟ್ ಲ್ಯಾಂಪ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್. ಫಾರ್ ಎ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮರ್ ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಎಕನಾಮಿಕಲ್ ಪವರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್? ದ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ 0.25 to 0.5 ಲ್ಯಾಗಿಂಗ್, ಬಿ 0.2 to 0.5 ಲೀಡಿಂಗ್, ಸಿ 0.85 to 0.95 ಲ್ಯಾಗಿಂಗ್, ಡಿ 0.85 to 0.95 ಲೀಡಿಂಗ್. ದ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸಿ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ 0.85 to 0.95 ಲ್ಯಾಗಿಂಗ್. ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಅವರ್ ಮೋಸ್ಟ್ ಆಫ್ ದ ಲೋಡ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಂಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಲೋಡ್. ಇನ್ ಎ ಪ್ಯೂರ್ ಇಂಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಸರ್ಕ್ಯೂಟ್ ದ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಲ್ಯಾಗ್ಸ್ ದ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ ಬೈ 90 degrees. ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ದಿಸ್ ಇಸ್ ಎ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್, ದ ಕರೆಂಟ್ ವಿಲ್ ಲ್ಯಾಗ್ಸ್ ದ ವೋಲ್ಟೇಜ್ ಬೈ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ 90 degrees, ದೆನ್ ದ ಪವರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಝೀರೋ. ಇಫ್ ಇಟ್ ಇಸ್ ಲ್ಯಾಗ್ಸ್ ಎಕ್ಸಾಕ್ಟ್ಲಿ 90 degrees, ದ ಪವರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಝೀರೋ. ದಟ್ ಮೀನ್ಸ್ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ ಲ್ಯಾಗಿಂಗ್. ಅವರ್ ಐಡಿಯಲ್ ಎಕನಾಮಿಕಲ್ ಪವರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಫ್ರಮ್ 0.85 to 0.95. ಆಕ್ಚುಲಿ ಇಟ್ ಈಸ್ 0.95. ದ ಡಿಸ್ಟ್ರಿಬ್ಯೂಷನ್ ಕಂಪ್ನೀಸ್ ಯುಟಿಲಿಟೀಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಗಿವ್ ಗೈಡೆನ್ಸ್ ಟು ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ 0.95 ಲ್ಯಾಗಿಂಗ್ ಪವರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಟು ಎ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮರ್ಸ್. ಇಫ್ ದೇ ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ ಲೆಸ್, ದೇ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಚಾರ್ಜ್ಡ್ ಮೋರ್. ಓಕೆ ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಈಸ್ ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಈಸ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ನಂಬರ್ 6. ದ ಪ್ರೈಮರಿ ರೀಸನ್ ಫಾರ್ ದ ಲೋ ಪವರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ ಈಸ್ ಡ್ಯೂ ಟು ದ ಇನ್ಸ್ಟಾಲೇಷನ್ ಆಫ್, ದ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇಂಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಮೋಟಾರ್ಸ್, ಡಿಸಿ ಮೋಟಾರ್ಸ್, ಸಿಂಕ್ರನ್ಸ್ ಮೋಟಾರ್ಸ್, ಕಾಮ್ಯುಟೇಟರ್ ಮೋಟಾರ್ಸ್. ದ ಮೇನ್ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಎ ಇಂಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಮೋಟಾರ್ಸ್. ಈ ಒಂದು ಅದರ್ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಮೋಟಾರ್ಸ್, ಈವನ್ ವಿ ಆರ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ವೈಂಡಿಂಗ್ಸ್, ದ ಮೇನ್ ಪ್ರೈಮರಿ ರೀಸನ್ ಈಸ್ ಇಂಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಮೋಟಾರ್ಸ್. ಓಕೆ, ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್, 7th ಕ್ವಶನ್. ಫಾರ್ ವಿಚ್ ಅಮಾಂಗ್ ದ ಫಾಲೋಯಿಂಗ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮರ್ಸ್ ಈಸ್ ಪೆನಾಲ್ಟಿ ಇಂಪೋಸ್ಡ್ ಫಾರ್ ಲೋ ಪವರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್? ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ರೆಸಿಡೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಅಂಡ್ ಕಮರ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮರ್ಸ್, ಬಿ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮರ್ಸ್, ಸಿ ಅಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರಲ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮರ್ಸ್, ಡಿ ಆಲ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿ ಎಬೋ. ಕ್ವಶನ್ ಏನಿದೆ, ಈ ತರ ಟೈಪ್ ಆಫ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮರ್ಸ್, ನಮ್ಮಲ್ಲಿ 4 ರೀತಿ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮರ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಇದ್ದಾರೆ. ಒಬ್ರು ರೆಸಿಡೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮರ್ಸ್, ನಾವು ರೆಸಿಡೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮರ್ಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ಮನೆಯವರು, ಮನೆಗಳಲ್ಲಿ ಪವರ್ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡೋರ್ನ ರೆಸಿಡೆನ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮರ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರಿತೀವಿ. ಕಮರ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮರ್ಸ್ ಅಂದ್ರೆ ನೀವು ಪಬ್ಲಿಕ್ ಬಿಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ಸು, ಗೌರ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಬಿಲ್ಡಿಂಗ್ಸು, ಆಮೇಲೆ ಮಾಲ್ಸು, ಶಾಪಿಂಗ್ ಕಾಂಪ್ಲೆಕ್ಸಸ್ಸು, ಭಾಳಷ್ಟು ಶಾಪ್ಸ್, ಇದೆಲ್ಲ ಕಮರ್ಷಿಯಲ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮರ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ. ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮರ್ಸ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಫ್ರಮ್ ವೆರಿ ಸ್ಮಾಲ್ ಸ್ಕೇಲ್ ಟು ವೆರಿ ಲಾರ್ಜ್ ಸ್ಕೇಲ್ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರೀಸ್ನ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮರ್ಸ್ ಅಂತ ಕರೀತಾರೆ. ಅಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರಲ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮರ್ಸ್ ಅಂದರೆ ಫಾರ್ ಅಗ್ರಿಕಲ್ಚರಲ್ ಪರ್ಪಸ್ ವಿಚ್ ದೇ ಆರ್ ಯೂಸಿಂಗ್ ದ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಟೈಪ್ಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಎಲೆಕ್ಟ್ರಿಸಿಟಿ ಫಾರ್ ಡಿಫ್ರೆಂಟ್ ಪರ್ಪಸ್. ಇದರಲ್ಲಿ ಯಾರಿಗೆ ನಾವು ಪೆನಾಲ್ಟಿ ಪೇ ಮಾಡುತ್ತೆ ಅಂದರೆ, ದ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಫಾರ್ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮರ್ಸ್. ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮರ್ಸ್ ವಿಲ್ ಇಂಪೋಸ್ ಎ ಪೆನಾಲ್ಟಿ, ಬಿಕಾಸ್ ಈ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮರ್ಸು ಮ್ಯಾಕ್ಸಿಮಮ್ ಇನ್ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರೀಸ್ ಮೋಟಾರ್ಸ್ನ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡೋದೇ ಇಂಡಕ್ಟಿವ್ ಟೈಪು, ಇಂಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಮೋಟಾರ್ಸ್. ಇಂಡಕ್ಷನ್ ಮೋಟಾರ್ಸ್ ಯೂಸ್ ಮಾಡೋದ್ರಿಂದ ನಮಗೆ ಪವರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರು ಭಾಳ ಕಡಿಮೆ ಇರುತ್ತೆ. ಅದಕ್ಕೋಸ್ಕರ ಪವರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್ನ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ಮಾಡ್ಕೊಳ್ಳೋದಕ್ಕೆ ಹೇಳ್ತಾರೆ. ಏನು, ಐಡಲಿ ಟು ಮೇಂಟೈನ್ ಎಬೋ ಆರ್ ಈಕ್ವಲ್ ಟು 0.95 ಲ್ಯಾಗಿಂಗ್. ಓಕೆ, ದ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಬಿ ಫಾರ್ ಬಿ ಇಂಡಸ್ಟ್ರಿಯಲ್ ಕನ್ಸ್ಯೂಮರ್ಸ್ ಫಾರ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ ನಂಬರ್ 7. ನೆಕ್ಸ್ಟ್ ಕ್ವಶನ್ 8, ಕ್ವಶನ್ ನಂಬರ್ 8. ವಾಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಕಾನ್ಸಿಕ್ವೆನ್ಸಸ್ ಆಫ್ ಲೋ ಪವರ್ ಫ್ಯಾಕ್ಟರ್? ಆಪ್ಷನ್ಸ್ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸ್ ದ ರೇಟಿಂಗ್ ಆಫ್ ಸ್ಟೇಷನ್ ಎಕ್ವಿಪ್ಮೆಂಟ್ ಓನ್ಲಿ, ಬಿ ಓನ್ಲಿ ಲೈನ್ ಲಾಸ್ ಇನ್ಕ್ರೀಸಸ್, ಸಿ ಬೋತ್ ಎ ಅಂಡ್ ಬಿ ಕಾಸಸ್, ಡಿ ನೈದರ್ ಆಫ್ ದಿಸ್. ದ ಆನ್ಸರ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಬೋತ್ ಎ ಅಂಡ್ ಬಿ, ದಟ್ ಈಸ್ ದ ಆಪ್ಷನ್ ವಿಲ್ ಬಿ ಸಿ. Because if it is a low power factor, the size, the requirement of KVA, the size of the equipment, conductor size, the equipment size will also, capacity will be increases. As we know, low power factor means the current will draw by the equipment or a machineries will be increased. As it is increased, the copper loss will be increased and the losses, line losses will also increase. Answer will be both A and B. Okay. Next question, question number 9. In a circuit, low reactive power compared to true power indicates, the options are low power factor, high power factor, low efficiency, high efficiency. The answer will be high power factor. In previous slides, starting early slides, I have discussed reactive power, true power, reactive power, apparent power. If the reactive power size is less, the power factor will be more. If the reactive power size is more, the power factor will be less. Here in the circuit, low reactive power compared to true power means it is high power factor. Okay. The answer will be high power factor for 9th question. Next, we will see 10th question. The power factor of an AC circuit is equal to, the options are cosine of the phase angle, sine of the phase angle, tangent of the phase angle, cotangent of the phase angle. The answer will be A, it is a cosine of the phase angle. Okay. These are the answers what we discussed in above MCQs, multiple choice questions. These are the references for these sessions. Okay, at last, we will conclude this session. In our electrical power system, a load with a low power factor means draws more current. Low power factor, it will draws more current than a load with high power factor for the same amount of useful power transferred. The higher the current, if it is higher the current means what it means, it increases the loss in distribution system and requires very large wires and other equipment size also increase. Because of the cost of the larger equipment and wasted energy, electrical utilities will usually charge a high cost to industrial or commercial consumers where there is a low power factor. If they maintain low power factor, they will charge more electricity bill. So ultimately, we have to maintain the power factor near to unity, that means 0.95 lagging. Okay. Thank you.